You need to be getting in staging and ready to go, please. Yeah, it looks like caution lights are out, and we're getting ready to come to green to winter. This one will be the pole sitter of tonight's series finale here at Tazewell Speedway. Off turn number four, they'll smash a loud pedal, green flags out, and here we go. Into turn number one, who's it going to be? It'll be the Aussie, Craig Weisbergen jumps to the race lead. Shannon Buckingham will be second. Fourth, Trent going to be third. Stacy Bowles fourth. Get only the top four transfer. Josh Fields going to be fifth here on the opening lap with one in the books here at the Bad Fast Taz, and Craig Weisbergen. Looking good here in the early going of this one. Buckingham in second as a Bowles and Trent close together there entering turn three. Trent got to hang on to that third spot for the time being. Shovel Bowles back to fourth. Fields in fifth. Steve Smith sixth. Jason Walker Rides in seventh. As we've got three down, seven to go, and Craig Weisbergen looking high, wide, and handsome here at the Bad Fast Taz so far in qualifying heat race number one. Down to complete lap number four, one lap shy of the halfway mark here in qualifying heat race number one. Weisbergen out front, Buckingham second, Trent in third. Then it's the 11 of Stacy Bowles in fourth, followed by the 11 of Josh Fields, who rides in the fifth spot, one side, one spot on the outside. Looking at it is 0.5 down, five remaining. Field work on lap number six, and Weisbergen continuing to show the way in the number eight machine. Buckingham riding in second still. Trent solidly in third, and Bowles solidly in fourth at this point. But Buckingham starting to close in on Weisbergen for the race lead. Off four down the front straightaway here, Main Street at Tazewell Speedway. As we got a lucky seven laps in the books, three to go. And they are going to encounter slower traffic possibly before this one's done. Buckingham right on Vosbergen's back bumper down into turn number one. As the Aussie will go to the bottom through turns one and two that time, gets a good bite. Gets a little bit of breathing room on Buckingham as they work off turn number four. White flag down, one lap to go here in qualifying heat race number one. Weisbergen working down the back chute for the final time. Set to set that car down into turn number three. Off of turn number four, Perth Western Australia's Craig Weisbergen wins qualifying heat number one. Shannon Buckingham will come home in second. Forrest Trent in the 101 will finish third. The 11B of Stacy Bowles will come home in fourth. Then it'll be Josh Fields, Steve Smith, and Jason Walker. So your top four finishers out of this one, finishing fourth, the 11B of Stacy Bowles, third to 101 of Forrest Trent, second to 50 of Shannon Buckingham, and picking up the win in the Longhorn. Maxima Racing Oil, Tennessee RV Supercenter, FK Rodians, Hoosier Tire, Tom's RV sponsored entry for the driver out of Perth Western Australia. Tazewell Speedway, give him a big round of applause, Craig Weisbergen. Yeah, it looks like caution lights are out, and we are getting set to come to green here in this one. So Sam's not making the call as they'll pull the trigger on him off turn number four here. Green flag's going to wave, and here we go. The drag race to turn number one. Who's it going to be? Billy Ogle Jr. and David Payne. They'll go side by side for the lead, just like they started down into turn three. Payne drifts high up the making. That opens the door for Billy the Kid to grab the race lead off four, put Ogle on the point with Payne in second. And they're almost three wide, thinking about it for third off turn number two right there. Chicky Barton in third, Jeff Newbert fourth, and Matt Henderson riding in fifth. Henderson looking beneath Newbert for the fourth spot off four down Main Street as they head toward turn number one with two in a books, eight to go in qualifying heat number two. Newbert trying to keep Henderson at bay. Five, six scheduled to start, five made to call, and four will transfer on to the Schaefer Oil AMA presented by Reese Monument. Right now, Billy Ogle Jr. short away out in front with David Payne riding into bridesmaid spot. Chicky Barton is third. Best battle on the track, though, is for that fourth and final transfer spot between the 86 of Jeff Newbert and the 17 of Matt Henderson as they race through turns one and two down the back straightaway. Newbert pushed a bit there off two. That may open the door for Henderson to go to third, go to that fourth spot. He'll fire the slider on Newbert and go to fourth off four. So put Henderson in a transfer spot now halfway to the house in this one. Five down, five to go. Ogle continuing to maintain a comfortable lead over second place running David Payne here at this point with six down. Chicky Barton holds down the third spot. Henderson still fourth and Newbert in fifth. As Ogle comes by and clicks lucky lap number seven up on the Tazewell Speedway Coca-Cola scoreboard there in turn one and two. He's got about a half straightaway advantage over second place running David Payne, as we'll have two laps remaining this time by two to go in qualifying heat number two. As Payne continues to show the way, or Ogle showing the way, and Payne trying to run him down right here as they're going to see the white flag. One lap to settle it here in qualifying heat number two. Down the back straightaway, they'll race for the final time. Off of turn number four, Knoxville, Tennessee's Billy Ogle Jr. will win qualifying heat number two. David Payne will come home in second. Third will be Chicky Barton. Fourth going to go to Matt Henderson. And finishing in fifth will be the 86 of Jeff Newbert. So your top four finishers in this one, finishing in fourth, the 17 of Matt Henderson, third, the 144 of Chicky Barton, second, the 8 of Craig Mossbergen, and grabbing the win in qualifying heat race number two, the Longhorn custom-powered Harrison Ready Mix Vanover and Sun Concrete sponsored entry. The driver out of Knoxville, Tennessee, former seven-time Tazewell Speedway track champion, give him a big round of applause, Billy Ogle Jr. And Dakota Knuckles had a top three finish here with the Iron Schaefer's Oil Ironman Series over the 4th of July holiday weekend.
No, he cannot come out.
As we get set to come to green, here we go. Green is out. And Dakota Knuckles going to jump to the race lead. McIntosh a little out of shape. That's going to let Big Hill get past him. As they work off turn number four, caution flag is out. Caution is out. And I believe the 54 of Sam's did miss the call for his heat race. He will have to pull to the infield. Caution lights go out. We'll see what happens here on take two of heat race number three. McIntosh and Knuckles pull the trigger on him off forehead. Here we go. They drag race to turn number one. Who's it going to be? McIntosh and Knuckles side by side for the lead. Down the back straightaway. Vic Hill going to be third. Kitty Collins up to fourth. As McIntosh almost got into Knuckles. Knuckles going to lead him through on lap number one. D-Mac going to be in second with Hill in third. Collins in fourth. And it's over Holt and Helton. Knuckles showing the way out in front here of this in this one right now, looking to be the outside pole setter for tonight's main event here in the early going of qualifying heat race number three. Knuckles your leader, McIntosh in second, Hill rides in third, Collins in that fourth and final transfer spot. Then it is Overholt and Helton with three in the books, field working lap number four. And the youngster out of Ewing, Virginia, looking good so far in this one as he is one lap shy of the halfway marker. Knuckles showing away. McIntosh in second. Vic Hill third. Kenny Collins fourth. And McIntosh tries to look to the inside of Knuckles off four, not able to make the move. As they'll race through turns one and two, halfway to the house in this one. Five down, five to go. McIntosh, he'll pull alongside of Knuckles again, but Knuckles up able to momentum that high side, and here comes the one of Vic Hill. He's chased down the front two, and he may get in on this action as well up front. We'll have a lucky seven laps complete this time by seven down, three to go for race leader Dakota Knuckles in the 21K. McIntosh riding in the bridesmaid spot right now with Vic Hill in third. Knuckles comes down, puts another lap up. There's two to go in this one, two to go in heat race number two, or excuse me, number three. Off of turn number four, we're going to see the white flag this time. One lap to go for Dakota Knuckles. And caution is out. Caution flag is out. As Phil Helton had issues over on the back straightaway. Caution lights are out. Green, white, checkered, going to settle it. Mr. Showtime bringing D-Mac in the thrill behind him. All four with two laps to go in qualifying heat number three. McIntosh looks beneath Knuckles, and McIntosh going to grab the lead from Knuckles off of turn number two. They'll come to the white flag, one lap to settle it. McIntosh will lead him down the back straightaway for the final time here in this one. Off of turn number four, Dawsonville, Georgia's Donovan McIntosh going to be your winner. Dakota Knuckles will come home in second. Third will be the one of Vic Hill. Fourth, the 1C of Kenny Collins. And fifth, we'll go to the four of Clyde Overholt. So your top four that transfer on to the main event out of this one, finishing in fourth, the 1C of Kenny Collins. Third, the one of Vic Hill. Second, the 21K of Dakota Knuckles, and picking up the win in qualifying heat race number three in the Blunt Motorsports Rocky Vic Hill powered Old Ben Franklin store, Cherokee Millwright, Blunt Excavating, Arnold's Trucking, Stowers Cat Service, sponsored number seven out of Dawsonville, Georgia. Big round of applause for D-Mac, Donald McIntosh. He'll be the outside pole sitter of tonight's main event. Now we get everybody grouped up two by two double file. And get set to come to green here in this one. As they get set to work off turn number four, here we go. And the caution lights are back on. Caution lights on. Caution is out. Overton may have been just a bit quick on the trigger right there. Bosbergen's going to be the pole sitter. McIntosh outside pole. Billy Ogle Jr. is going to start third. The winner of this one starts in fourth. Overton and Neely set to bring them to green here off turn number four. Green's going to wave, and here we go. They're down to turn a number one and two. Brandon Overton with the race lead. Austin Neely going to be second. Brian Smith third. Farrell Skelton racing in the fourth spot at this point as they work off turn number four down the front straightaway with one lap officially in the book. Overton showing away. Neely in second. Smith third. Skelton fourth. Then it is Mitchell Burke in fifth. Chad Ogle sixth. And the 25 machine of Kevin Sams in seventh. Overton, we got caution. Caution is out as Sams has swatted the concrete up here in turn number one. If we get set to bring up the green here off turn number four, green's going to wave it. Here we go. Overton leads the field into turn one and off of turn two down the back straightaway. Brian Smith looking beneath Austin Neely. Down into turn three, they make a little contact. Smith clear of Neely now for that second position. As the field haul in the mail here tonight at Tazewell Speedway. It is all Brandon Overton here in the early going of this one. Three laps in the book, and Overton out to almost a full straightaway advantage over second place running Brian Smith. Austin Neely third. Farrell Skelton in the fourth position right now. Chad Ogle is fifth. Mitchell Burke, Ryan's in sixth. And Overton continuing to stretch his lead. We'll be halfway to the house right here. Five down, five to go in the fourth and final qualifying heat race of the night. Brian Smith second, Austin Neely third, as Farrell Skelton battles with Chad Ogle now for that fourth and final transfer spot down the back straightaway. As Overton puts lap number six up on the board, and if we stay green, he's probably going to encounter some traffic before this one is all said and done. Seven laps now in the books. Overton coming down. He'll put lap number eight up on the board this time. Eight down, two to go here in the final qualifying heat race of the night. Overton with it well in hand. He's about to see Bruce Kaler's white flag. One lap to go in a qualifying heat race number four here tonight at Tazewell Speedway. And into turn three and off of turn four, Evans, Georgia's Brandon Overton will be the winner of heat number four. Brian Smith going to be second. Austin Neely going to come home in third. Who's it going to be for the fourth and final transfer spot? Give it to the 25 of Chad Ogle. Chad Ogle will come home in the fourth position. Farrell Skelton will be fifth. So your top four that transfer on out of this one. Chad Ogle finishes fourth in the 25, the three in of Austin Neely third, the seven of Brian Smith second, and the winner of qualifying heat number four in the CrossFit Overton, AF Stone Professional Medical Services, Longhorn by Weaver, Mission Transport Stone, Land Clearing and Excavating Machine out of Evans, Georgia. Big round of applause for Brandon Overton. Yeah, it looks like we're getting set to come to green here in tonight's B main. Couple of cars not making the call there. Josh Fields, Clyde Overholt set to bring them to green. Green waves, and here we go. Top four going on to the main event, and unless they got a series provisional, everybody else going to transfer the trailer and be done for the night. Farrell Skelton going to go around, and they've stacked him up in turn number three. Farrell Skelton going around there, and Mitchell Burke and Jason Walker also involved. As we get set to come back to green here in the B main, Clyde Overholt going to jump to the race lead. Josh Fields going to be second. Steve Smith in third. Farrell Skelton is fourth. Jeff Newbert in fifth. With a one lap officially in the book now. Overholt leads him through on lap number one. Fields second. Smith third. Skelton in fourth. And Newbert trying to get around Skelton for that fourth and final transfer spot as Overholt shows the way out in front in the number four machine. As we'll have four laps scored this time. Four laps of 10 will be in the books right here. Overholt continuing to lead the way. Josh Fields second. Steve Smith in third. As they work off turn number four to complete another lap. Five down, five to go. Overholt on the point. Fields in second. Smith in third. Newbert is fourth. And Skelton in fifth. As Overholt looking to lead him home here in this one. He'll have seven laps scored this time. Seven down, three remaining. Overholt on the point still. Fields in second. Smith in third, Newbert in fourth, Skelton in fifth. Eight laps down, less than two to go now for Clyde Overholt, showing away here out in front of this one. He'll come to the white flag, one lap to settle it right here. Overholt leads him down the back straightaway for the final time and into turn three off of turn number four. It'll be Townsville, Tennessee's Clyde Overholt grabbing a win in the Super Late Model B main. Josh Fields going to come home in second. Third will be Steve Smith. And fourth will go to Jeff Newbert. So your top four finishers, fourth, the 86 of Jeff Newbert. Third, the three of Steve Smith. Second will be the 11 of Josh Fields and picking up the win in tonight's B main for the Schaefer's Oil Southern National Super Late Models out of Tazewell, Tennessee, the number four. Big round of applause for Clyde Overholt. Again, we need all of you great race fans that are standing down there next to the catch fence area. Please make your way back to your seat in the main grandstands, please. Thank you. As the first of a select group of parade laps get underway here for the series finale tonight. The hot pit work area down there in the center of the infield. And you see them start to go into that four wide salute. Race fans, Tazewell Speedway, we want all of you on your feet. Wave your hands, caps, the four-wide Schaefer Oil Rally towels. Get the lights on the cell phones. Get the fireflies buzzing around. For the final time in 2017, It's the Schaefer's Oil Southern Nationals presented by Sunoco Race Fuel and Tennessee RV Supercenter, the 2017 Series Finale presented by Reese Monument here at Tazewell Speedway. Race fans, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, here they are. And the field getting the one to go signal. Race fans, we are coming to green next time by. The 2017 Series Championship points hangs in the balance. Overton with 20 points over Buckingham and 28 over McIntosh. Vosburgen and McIntosh will bring them to green. Tazewell Speedway, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's showtime. They'll drag race to turn number one. Who's it gonna be? Vosburgen. Vosburgen gonna come out of there with the race lead here on lap number one. As they come down, Vosburgen gonna lead them through. McIntosh gonna be in second. Ogle looks to be in third. Overton fourth, and Knuckles in fifth here on the opening lap of this one. Vosburgen leads them through. McIntosh in second, Ogle third, Overton fourth, Knuckles rides in fifth, Buckingham sixth, Payne in seventh, Trent in eighth, Hill ninth, and Brian Smith tenth here on the opening lap of this one. And McIntosh closes up on Vosburgen, looking for the lead off turn number four, not able to get the job done. Four laps of 51 in the books. McIntosh again challenging Vosburgen for the lead, while Overton right there on Ogle's back bumper. That is for the third position. As the 83 of Jason Walker pulls his machine in, he's going to call it a night here early in this one. The front four of Vosburgen, McIntosh, Ogle, and Overton put a little bit of distance between himself and fifth place running Dakota Knuckles. Is Overton trying to work beneath Ogle off two, not able to get the job done. Farrell Skelton pulls the 0F in as well. Yes, they're clicking the laps off. We've got a lucky seven in the book. Seven down, 44 remain here in this one. And we're going to be into some heavy traffic here in just a moment. Yes, McIntosh again looking to the inside of Vosburgen. But the Aussie hanging on to the top spot here for the time being. But now's when business is probably going to pick up at the point. As McIntosh looks to the inside of Vosburgen as they have encountered traffic now as we will complete lap number nine. McIntosh continues to work to the inside of Vosburgen but not able to make a move at this point. As Ogle and Overton starting to close in on that front pair, Knuckles holds down the fifth position. 10 laps into this one, a fifth of the way through, if you will. As McIntosh again looking beneath Vosburgen, not able to make a move. As Overton splits a slower car trying to get a run on Ogle for the third position, but he's been unsuccessful at this point. As Buckingham challenges Dakota Knuckles now for the final spot in the top five. Vosburgen and McIntosh dueling for the lead. And McIntosh may have it at 116. They're three wide for the second spot, and Overton goes from fourth to second. All of this on lap number 13. McIntosh now the race leader. As Chicky Barton's 144 slows at the bottom of turn number two, he's going to duck that machine into the pit area. And we've got caution. Caution is out. Personnel attending to Chicky Barton, who we think may have lost the drive shaft on the 144. As the caution lights are out, as we get set to come to green, here we go. McIntosh leads them off into turn number one. Overton trying to roll the high side. He is in second. Ogle going to be third. Knuckles looking to get fourth here on the restart. as Vossbergen has slipped a bit here. Battle for the lead between the 7 of McIntosh and the 116 of Overton. We've got 17 trips in the book, 17 down, 34 remain, and one third of the way home. McIntosh on the point, Overton second, Ogle in third, Dakota Knuckles in fourth, Shannon Buckingham fifth, David Payne rides in the sixth spot. As McIntosh, looks like the tires have fired here once again, and he has pulled away a bit from second place running Brandon Overton at this point. Down the back straightaway they'll go. They're going to have 20 laps on the Coca-Cola scoreboard here at Tazewell Speedway this time by 20 down, 31 remain. McIntosh showing away with Overton still riding in second. Billy Ogle Jr. is third. Dakota Knuckles rides in fourth. Shannon Buckingham fifth. David Payne sixth. Big Hill seventh. Craig Vossbergen eighth. Forrest Trent ninth. And Brian Smith the final car in the top 10. And if we stay green, business is going to pick up because they are going to get into some lap traffic here at the point. McIntosh and Overton will have to try to pick their way through this slower traffic here at the rear of the field. Overton looking to the inside of McIntosh for the lead off four, not able to get the job done. 23 in the books. And it gets a bit hairy here in lap traffic for just a moment. As we're back into traffic here on lap 24. McIntosh still holds the lead. Overton is second. Ogle got to be in the third spot. Knuckles fourth. Buckingham still at fifth. As McIntosh working traffic to the best of his ability here at this point in the contest. Overton holding down that second position. Great run tonight for Billy Ogle Jr., the former seven-time Tazewell Speedway track champion. He rides in the third spot. Then it's Knuckles still fourth, Buckingham fifth, Payne sixth, Hill in seventh, Vossbergen eighth, Forrest Trent ninth, Brian Smith tenth. 27 laps down, 24 to go, two dozen remaining in this one. And McIntosh continues to show the way out in front. Brandon Overton rides in second and closes back up on McIntosh's bumper again as they work off turn number four. But McIntosh with a great run off of turn number four works down the front straightaway. Next car he's going to have to negotiate will be the 11 of Josh Fields as he works to put him a lap down here off of turn number four. Down the front, shoot it into turn number one with 30 in the books, 21 to go. Overton with a run off the high side. Thought about taking a look beneath McIntosh there, but thought better of it. He'll fall back in line as McIntosh now will slide up in front of the car of Josh Fields, put him a lap down. Overton now going to try to look to the inside of McIntosh for the lead off of four, not able to get the job done. Ogle continues to hold down that third spot. Knuckles in fourth, Buckingham in fifth. And Vic Hill has closed in on Buckingham, who now from his sixth spot. As McIntosh puts lap 33 up, 18 laps to go here in this one. And he's going to have to negotiate the cars of Stacy Bowles and Matt Henderson now as he tries to work his way past that pair and put them a lap down. He's around the 17 of Henderson. Overton will do the same around Henderson now. Ogle in third, Knuckles fourth, and Buckingham continues to hold down the final position in the top five. They'll come by this time. We'll have 36 laps in the books, 36 down, 15 laps to go. Donald McIntosh got an excellent hot rod here tonight at Tazewell Speedway. And we're going to have caution. Caution is out as Matt Henderson's machine has slowed here on the front straightaway. Caution flag is out. Six laps are complete. As they get ready to come back to green, McIntosh pulls the trigger on them off four, and here we go. He'll lead them off of turn at number two down the back straightaway. Ogle trying to look beneath Overton for second as Buckingham looks to the outside of Knuckles. They're going to be three wide for third down the front straightaway. Knuckles trying to work to the inside of Ogle to grab that third spot, but we got a caution. Caution is out. As Stacy Bowles spins down in turn number four. It looks like we are getting set to come to green. Lights are out. 15 circuits remain. McIntosh pulls the trigger on him off four, and we're back underway. Here we go. Through turns one and two, McIntosh lead him down the back straightaway. Overton will be second. Ogle third. Knuckles once again fourth. Buckingham fifth. As Payne thought about ducking beneath Buckingham for the fifth spot, but could not get the job done right there. Meanwhile, McIntosh and Overton appear to be the drivers. They're going to settle this one amongst themselves with a baker's dozen, 13 remaining. McIntosh with the race lead. Overton wants it, and Ogle sitting right there in third in case something happens in front of him. When they come by this time, there will be 11 laps to go. 11 laps remaining. McIntosh and Overton still 1-2. Ogle third, Knuckles fourth, Buckingham fifth, Payne sixth, Vosbergen 7th, Smith 8th, Trent 9th, and Austin Neely, the final car in the top 10, with less than 10 to go here in the Shapers Oil 2017 Southern National Series finale presented by Reese Monument. McIntosh leading the way in the 7. Overton rides in 2nd. Ogle still 3rd. Knuckles 4th. Buckingham 5th. Payne 6th. Vosbergen in 7th. As we've got 8 laps remaining now. And Overton trying to get a run on McIntosh. Trying to find a way around the young man in the 7M. But he has been unsuccessful up to this point. And we're going to have a quick 6 dash left this time. There will be 6 laps to go here at Tazewell Speedway. Overton trying to look again beneath McIntosh, not able to get the job done right there. As McIntosh and Overton, they're going to settle this thing amongst themselves. With 5 remaining. And if we stay green, we're going to catch some traffic before this one is done, folks, with 4 to go. McIntosh will bring them through and complete lap number 48. And Overton goes to the outside of McIntosh, grabs the race lead. White flag in the air, 1 lap to settle it. Overton with a daring move there, coming to 2 to go, grabs the race lead. Through turns 3 and off turn number 4, Brandon Overton will win at Tazewell Speedway. Donald McIntosh will come home in 2nd. Billy Ogle Jr. gonna be 3rd. Dakota Knuckles 4th, and Shannon Buckingham completes the top 5. He's out of the car. He can hear you, Tazewell Speedway. Give him a big round of applause. Picks up the series finale victory by Reese Monument. Great job out there tonight. Talk about the move that you made off turn 4 coming to 2 to go.
That second caution we had there, I was telling the boys, the brakes are going slam to the floorboard. And I was like, man, I come down here on that restart when I chose the inside, and I pushed up, and I said, dang, we're done. I just need to make sure I don't kill nobody here and just get our points or whatever. And we had, a caution on lap 35 or whatever, and I started pushing them, and they were coming back. You know, I was like, all right, well, I just ain't going to use them until I need to. So I just waited till we got in traffic, you know, just kept putting enough pressure on Donald. I seen his guys down there tell him hi, low, you know, which they're trying to win the race too. But I just waited till the opportunity came, and I seen we was closing in on that traffic, and I wanted to be there, to strike when I could. So I said he bobbed when he should have weaved. So good job of them guys. And like I said, I can't thank all these sponsors enough. We got all of our car owners here tonight, Chip Stone, Rusty Stone, Randy Weaver, everybody's here. Got the guys from CrossFit Overton here, Mission Transport, Henderson Motorsports, Ted Brown Paint and Body, Outlaw Graphics, Andy Durham Race Engines, dude, this thing is bad to the bone, KB Carburetors, JRI Shocks, all my boys, Josh Pearl, Vinny Kirk, I couldn't do it without them, they bust their butt, they work so hard to bring this thing to the racetrack for me to drive. So, like I said, all in all, we done what we came to do, and we just take it on to the house.
Is Castle Speedway a racetrack that sometimes, especially when you get in traffic, is it better to be running in second than to be leading the race?
Yeah, definitely. I could sit right there and watch what he was doing. You know, like I said, we could run higher, lower, whatever, but I was trying not to kill my tires. You know, we're on a hard tire, and you can't abuse these things for 50 laps. So I just waited. Like I said, I waited, and then I thought I was done. I was just trying not to hurt nobody out there and just get my points. But like I said, when I started feeling them coming back, my eyes lit up. I knew we had a good car, but, you know, so they. And just you don't want to press the issue when you're trying to points race and trying to be smart, trying not to turn nothing up. So I said, we got the job done. I guess I just made the right call tonight. And like I said, well, appreciate all these fans coming out, dude. This is awesome. I know it's a hell of a racetrack for them to come watch. Just can't thank them enough. Can't thank Schaefer's Oil, everybody would race deal. You know, this has been an awesome, awesome experience. You know, I run that Outlaw deal, and this is about as close as you can get to it. It gets pretty grueling sometimes. It's an awesome little deal for anybody around our area to run. So I can't thank all them guys enough.
He'll win the championship by 30 points. He's the 17 Spring Nationals and the 17 Southern Nationals champion. Race fans out of Evans, Georgia, one more time, big round of applause for Brandon Overton. And real quick, talk to the gentleman that finished second in series points, or excuse me, third in series points. He comes home second place tonight. Donald McIntosh out of Dawsonville, Georgia. Young man, you had a bad fast race car tonight. You absolutely drove the wheels off that sucker, done everything you could to put it in victory lane, lap traffic. You just want to kick them out of the way, I guess, or whatever. But, young man, you done a great, great job out there tonight.
Man, it's been a fun series. I can't thank these guys enough. They were a little better than we were tonight, man. Him get up there on the top like that, I didn't expect it. I got into him because I didn't expect him to be out there. But he did a great job the whole series, man. This was fun. We had a lot of good fun, and hate to lead it that long and lose it there at the end. But I can't thank these guys enough. Vic Hill Race Engines, we did it all in one car. So what an awesome thrill. You know, I keep getting closer at this track. It keeps biting me a little bit and coming up a little bit short. But what a fun series.
And so, and I know you've had a lot of good runs here, and you got to feel like, man, this place owes me one big time. You definitely come up a little short tonight, but everybody's know you've been in this points chase. You've been there. You got three series wins. So you've had a good run in the series in 2017.
Oh, no doubt. I'm proud of where we're at. Obviously, like to have been a little better, but like I said, I'm proud of this team. We did the best we could, and we had a lot of fun. You know, to be able to race with Brandon Overton, one of the best in the country right now. So, and I'm proud.
Big round of applause to Haswell Speedway, tonight's runner-up finisher, third and final series points, Dawsonville, Georgia's Donald McIntosh.
Here we are with third place finisher tonight at Tazewell Speedway, Billy Ogle Jr. Man, you had a fine run going tonight, Billy.
For us, that's a real good run. You know, it's about like a win for me the way things have gone the last year or so. And, I've been wanting to at least get a podium for a long while. And we've just had bad luck. And we wrecked our new car a couple weeks ago, and we had to go back to the old car. But, we did some stuff to the old car that we learned off the new car, and I think we made it better. And that car is pretty competitive now. I'm I think we still have a little work to do, but I think we definitely are getting better. You know, this team's a startup, so I got to thank Glenn Vanover for what he's doing for me. And, you know, it's a big take. It's a big take, you know, a big monumental task taking that on, a late model team in today's racing. It's really different than it used to be. You know, I've been around it a long time, and I've seen it change, and it just keeps changing. And who knows what it'll be 10 years from now. I'm excited to see it, but my career will be over by then, but I'll still be watching it probably.
As long as you got fans like me, your career won't be over.
I hope not. I still think I got maybe 10 years left, I hope. I think I do. You look at Billy Moyer Sr., and he still can drive as good as any of them, I think. And I think Steve Smith can still drive as good as any of them. You put him in a good car, he just had some bad luck tonight because he was one of the fastest cars before he busted a tire and messed up his qualifying. But anyway, I'm proud to run third tonight. It's a big plus for us, and it's a lot of momentum for us. Vanover Concrete, I got to thank Glenn Vanover. I got to thank Harrison Ready Mix, our concrete people, Custom Race Engines, and that's about it. We have a Hoosier Race Attire on right now, too.
All right, third place finisher tonight at Tazewell Speedway, Billy Ogle Jr.
And I'd also like to thank my sponsors, Vanover Concrete with Glenn Vanover, Reynolds Racing, and Backley Baggett Pharmacy. That's some of our main sponsors, and Custom Race Engines, and Harrison Ready Mix. And those are my main sponsors. Thank you. You might have to dub.